Welcome back to Orchid House. I'm Olivier in Fort Lauderdale, and today I want to talk about bad news because I got an attack of bacterial infection on all the Stanopias, Gongoras. This is a Coelogeny. And so basically what I started noticing, I had my big Gongora. I made a video about that plant a while back. Was very happy at five new bulbs, a fresh set of leaves, and all of a sudden I noticed the next day that the leaves were covered with brown and black marks. And I panicked, I'm like, what on earth is happening? So I sprayed peroxide, put the plant aside, and inspected the neighboring plants, and one of them had two or three mini marks, and I'm like, well, I'll keep an eye on it. Well, the next day the plant was engulfed. All the leaves were covered with it. So since then I've been quarantining plants left and right, but it kept on spreading. This is a Coelogeny, but it's the same type of leaf. So basically this type of damage, that happened overnight practically. So you have one or two little marks, and then the next day the entire leaf is gone. This one I've only had a month, so it was doing really well. I bought it with a tiny shoot. The shoot was growing nicely. This is Usitena. It already has a flower growing, and guess what? It's in very bad shape now. I hope it's not gonna die. Now, the second plant that got hit was my Platyceras, which is a Stanopia which had six huge leaves, a very good Stanopia. Bloomed twice last year. So the good news, you see there's still a spike actually here, and there's some roots growing over there. Don't know if you can see them. So it seems that it's just a foliar disease, and then the disease stops at the bulbs. If you have a problem that starts with the roots, then you're basically in real big trouble because you're going to lose all your plants. Now I'm probably still going to lose some of my Stanopias, the smaller ones. They may not be able to rebound. But I was way out of my league here, so I contacted Ron McHatton at the American Orchid Society. And so first of all, it's really tough to determine where it came from. The likely culprit is that we have cold fronts coming from the north here in South Florida, and they don't really do much except that we have big showers at times, and then the night comes and temperatures drop, and maybe there was too much wetness on the leaves and that's how it started, but we'll never know. Now, because I was using peroxide, and it was doing a little bit of an effect, but I mean, the thing kept on spreading, and I mean, I have like 50 Stanopias, Gongoras, and such, so that's a lot of plants. And so the peroxide is great, but only as a topical protection. So if the tissues are damaged, that's not going to take care of it. So I thought, well, copper will. Apparently most copper fungicides, again, are topical or preventative, but they are not systemics. They don't go through the vascular system of the plant. So what I was recommended to use, it's copper sulfate pentahydrate. That's the main ingredient. This is a product, what do you need? A product called Phyton that we have in the United States, and that's a systemic. So that I have to spray all the leaves and then also drench the media, and then it probably is going to require 2, 3, 4 applications 1 week apart. But I've already seen the impact now. I mean, the spreading is dramatically reduced. Some plants are completely stabilized, and I'm going to continue applying it. I've been treating preventively all my plants just in case, although I haven't seen anything on Vandas or on Cattleyas or even on Psidiums don't seem to be impacted, the Catasetums neither, so it seems to be more the type of Stanopias. But so basically if you see this type of damage, you have a little bit of brown, this is already far advanced, a little bit of brown spots, and then the next day your leaf, look here, maybe this is a better example how it starts. This is kind of stabilized now, it hasn't spread. I think the product is doing its what it's supposed to do. If you see that the next day your leaf is engulfed, you know that you have a pretty big problem. You need to act right away. So quarantining the plant is one thing to do, and then that systemic copper treatment is what you want to do. So I hope it never happens to you. I typically don't have problems with diseases, but this is a scary one, and it's done a lot of damage, and it's kind of a heartbreaker. But anyway, thanks for tuning in. Have a good day. Bye-bye.